We learn to adapt. We have new things now. You have things like online dating. 1 in 5 relationships is formed online now. That's a true statistic. I have a friend, he met his wife on one of those sites, and I asked him, I was like, so, what'd you search? Because that's weirdly romantic. He types in this phrase, all these algorithms and things come together, this woman's face comes up, he clicks it, that becomes the woman he spends the rest of his life with. So I asked him, what'd you search? And he goes, Jewish and my zip code. What? That's all you were looking for? Just something Jewish close by? You don't have to drive too far? Proximity was a big factor here. Jewish and my zip. I found a Wendy's that way a few weeks ago. I typed Wendy's and my zip code. Then I got some nuggets. He got a wife the exact same way. Some people still don't want to do online dating. Feel like there's a stigma to it. You know, but that's strange though. You ask those same people, hey, you ever meet people in bars? So I was like, yeah, sure, why not? Don't you see online dating is the same thing? It's just a different interface. In a bar, you walk around, you see people's faces. Online, you see those same faces, they're on a web page. The difference is, online dating is like going into a bar and having superpowers. You know what I mean? Online dating is like being able to walk into a bar and just go, all right, let's just eliminate all the other dudes. Let's eliminate any women that are already in relationships. You can do crazy things like that. You can't do that in the real world. In the real world, you can't walk into a bar and go, Jewish and my zip code.